When I was around 8 years old, this was in Nova Scotia. We grew up in Cape Breton. And I was around 8 years old and I first heard the word God. And I was outside playing and the person said to me that God lives up in the sky. So I said, oh, really? You know, what does that mean? So then when I arrived in Toronto when I was around 10, I had met this girl in my building that wanted to go to church. So I decided that, you know, okay, well, let me go and find out, you know, what church is all about. And even though I had a Christian background somewhat, but my parents don't really practice anything, so I you know, I just kept going to different churches and I found that there was too many inconsistencies. So I always had that need, you know, to learn, to know about my creator, if there was a creator. So when I was around 24 years old, I was in school and I had met this young man. And I also had met, he was a Muslim, actually, but he wasn't a practicing Muslim. So I also had met a girl in my class that was wearing full hijab, like myself, and she had a face covering on. So I had asked her, you know, why does she wear that on her face? And, you know, it looked so strange to me, right? So I said, well, can you tell me why you wear that? And she had explained to me that in Islam, you know, the beauty of a woman, a Muslim woman, is something that is so honored and respected that we don't share it with everybody, so we conceal it. And it's also, you know, backed up from the Quran that Muslim women have to cover. So I thought that was interesting. So then I said, okay, fine. I left it. And I had a relationship with this man at school. He was like a boyfriend. So I had later... I also had another friend. I'm not going to mention his name, but he was an Arab and he was Christian. And he thought, I guess, at the time that I was going to convert to Islam because I had this boyfriend. And even though I had no interest, really, about Islam, right? So he actually prompted me to learn about Islam because he used to bring, he used to work at this gas station close to my neighborhood. And he used to bring me information protesting, going completely against Islam, saying that Muslim women are, like, I guess I should be honest and say exactly what he said, that are whores and that they're allowed to have more than one man, right? And this is actually coming from the Quran, he said. So I said, oh, I said, you know, I said to this guy, I'm like, I really don't think that's true. I said, because, like, my reference point back to the girl at school, I said, this doesn't make any sense, right? And I said, why would she cover if she was promiscuous? So I said, well, I don't know about that. So I said, and I guess in his mind, he was trying to get me away from, you know, converting because he thought, you know, because of this Muslim boyfriend, he was going to marry me. Or it was like he was in a panic, you know, like telling me, bringing literature to me. He would bring literature to my mother at the store and pass it up to my mother. So I said, you know, I don't even want to read this. I said, I'm not interested in any, you know, anything about this. So I just said I got fed up, and that made me interested. So I decided to go to the mosque and find out about what Islam was. And to be honest, I didn't really find out too much from there. And I thought, you know, from what I did learn, that he was wrong. There was nothing in the Quran that stated that Muslim women are allowed to be promiscuous in any way. So I thought my journey ended. But it didn't. It actually just begun from there. So I went back, and I later found out that, you know, I was pregnant for the Muslim guy at school, and but he had left me. So I was now 5 months pregnant, and I was on the subway going to this new school. And from there, I looked up. I was sitting on the subway, and I looked up, and I saw Saliha, the girl that I had met with the full hijab at school, prior, like before. And I'm like, oh, I said, hi, how are you? And she's like, fine. And I said, where are you going? And she's like, well, I'm going to this new school. And I said, well, what when? It just so happened that we were both going to the same school now. We became very good friends. And I learned a lot about Islam from her. And it was never, you know, I wasn't really, like, before going to the masjid or the mosque and inquiring for myself. I you know, Islam just came to me now. And, you know, I became friends with her and a few other girls at school, and she would often invite me, you know, to her house. And I learned so much about Islam, you know, the character of a Muslim. And, you know, and also I found very interesting was that she actually memorized the Quran, which is, like, to me just a book at the time, and it was like word for word. She memorized it, and I was like, wow, this is amazing. So I wanted to know, like, what was in this book? You know, what was so amazing about a book that someone would memorize word for word? And, you know, there's just so many things that, you know, that amazed me. And being around a Muslim person, a practicing Muslim person, do you see the beauty of Islam? And I don't know how to sum that up or give you one particular point, but I would go to her home and I would see how she would interact, how she would dress, how she would eat, even how she prayed. I mean, I was out with them numerous times where she would, you know, say, oh, Crystal, you know what, I have to go pray. I have to find a place to pray. I found that amazing. Like, you're just going to stop from, and it was wintertime, you know, freezing, you know. And they were just a big support for me, especially at the time when I had nobody, you know. To be honest, I still wasn't interested in converting to Islam at all. I just said, nice religion, but not for me. So after I had my daughter, I started realizing, like, what am I going to teach my daughter? Like, what am I going to teach my daughter? Like, how am I going to grow my daughter up? I'm going to cry because it's emotional. So anyway, the guy, he never came back, you know. He did after I had my daughter, right? He wanted to, like, I had inquired about him to see her. But so I didn't really know how to, you know, raise this beautiful baby that I had. So, and I remember back to how Celia was and how her parents raised her, and I just saw this, you know, another way of living, right? Other than my way, which was basically just you live and you do whatever you like in this world. You want to do this, you go do it. There's no direction in life. So I decided to look more into Islam at that point on my own, you know. So Celia now got pregnant and she started working at the masjid just not far from here. And I said, well, Celia, I'm going to pop over. And, you know, every day, because I was home with my daughter, and I said, let me just come over and, you know, we'll talk about the Quran. I want to know more about it. It was hard. It was hard to find the concept of, you know, what is God. And from these experiences that I had at the masjid, I came to realize that there was a God. And, you know, one day I decided, you know, to go to the mosque. My daughter was 6 months at this point, and I was there, and I was in the room. And, you know, like, I was serious. I really wanted to know about this religion before I converted, because I never was baptized before. I never had any, you know, conversion to any religion. So I wanted to find out, you know, really was this for me, you know. And from there, I was there one day just, you know, like every other day, just visiting her in the office and talking about Islam and God and who he was and, you know, what Islam can offer me and my daughter. And so one day there was a funeral of a baby girl, and from there I just thought, life's so short, you know, like, you have to really make a decision about where you're going. So I converted that day. I accepted Islam, right, but I didn't know how to pray, you know. I didn't even have Islamic clothes. I was going back home now to, you know, my house. That was my mother. How was I going to explain that to my mother? You know, and there wasn't a lot of support for the new Muslim, because I think, and it's not saying that Muslim people that are born in Islam don't care. I think they care a lot. It's just that maybe there's, you know, not relating to the fact that, you know, she looks like a Muslim. She's got hijab on. She must have a Muslim family. They assume. They don't know what you're going home to. My life is different because, well, I just think of one thing. Maybe this might be not the best thing to say, but health-wise, I'm so much more healthy. I used to smoke. I don't have to say that, but I used to smoke and I used to drink. I used to get sick to my stomach from drinking. I don't drink anymore. I haven't tasted a drop of alcohol. I haven't smoked. Alhamdulillah. It's just, you know how many times I tried to quit smoking? I smoked for like 11 years, and I tried and tried and tried. I am a successful non-smoker right now. And I just owe that to God, because there's no way I could have done it. Like, especially, you know, with the support of the type of people I'm around, you know. It's your environment, you know. My environment is so much more healthy. I have direction in my life. I have more spirituality in my life. Like, I feel that I know why I'm here, you know. Like, I wake up in the morning and it makes sense. Like, I actually know why I'm here on earth. Before, it's like you're just here and you're like, what are you doing here? I used to have conversations with my friends, my non-Muslim friends, and say, we would come up with ideas why we're here, but now I know. That gives you direction. That gives you a lot of confidence, right? That you're not alone. And so I'm better spiritually, mentally, emotionally. My daughter, oh, you know, I see a future that is with God in her life, not like how I grew up. And that entails many, many positive things, you know. I always dream, like, you know, she's going to grow up and she's going to be better than me, you know, like much better. You know, she won't go through all the things that I went through, because she's going to be protected by Islam. You know, like, drinking won't be in her life. Having boyfriends, maybe having children without someone there with her, you know, like what I went through. You know, I want her to know the value of herself, and I think she will. Islam will teach her the value of who she is.